So I want to go back over to the White House. Kathryn, I understand that we are hearing for the first time from the president's legislative affairs director. What is he saying?
Absolutely. I was just hoping you might mention that. Let me read this comment from Eric Ulan, really the first on the record comment we're hearing. He is the president's legislative director, or the White House legislative director. He says, so the president is gratified that finally, at long last, after multiple delays, the Senate will set a schedule for his acquittal as quickly as possible. We do not believe that that schedule interferes with his ability to deliver a strong and confident State of the Union message next week in the House of Representatives to the country and the world. So the White House really getting that message across that, no, we don't think that this is going to mess up the State of the Union, and a lot of confidence in that statement.
A lot of confidence certainly coming out of the White House. Now, they had expected that the vote would fail in the call for witnesses today. That was after uncertainty in the days that preceded it, with Senate Majority Leader Mitch McConnell saying that he did not have the votes to block witnesses at one point. That changed this morning when Senator Lisa Murkowski said that she was disappointed in the Senate, but she did not feel like there was reason to hear from more witnesses. So, Kathryn, tell us more about what we've learned about the White House and how they feel, really, about the trial potentially extending into next week, now that we understand that Democrats and Republicans, it sounds like, have come to a basic agreement that the actual vote on whether or not to acquit the president will take place on Wednesday.
Well, I think there's really a settling into the realities, the legislative realities of the Senate. This is not known to be a fast-moving body. It likes to call itself the greatest deliberative body in the world. So, you know, it really should not be that much of a surprise that it's taking a couple weeks, a little more than a couple of weeks, to get through this entire really large, historic process. So even the president, as Major Garrett reported earlier today, it had kind of come to terms with the reality that this might be something that needed to happen, a little bit of a longer trial than the White House had initially hoped for. So, hey, that's just how it is. At the end of the day, the White House recognizes that the most important thing to them is that the president is acquitted and is able to say that. So it's frustrating to the president, I'm sure, that he isn't able to say that at his State of the Union address, that this vote is going to come one day after. Wednesday afternoon is what we've been hearing from these Republican senators. But that's just how it is. And at the end of the day, the president is almost certainly going to be able to say that he has been vindicated. And, you know, that's what matters most to him.